you went out the corner of my eye. I saw a pretty little thing approaching me. She said, I never seen a man who looks so all alone. Could you use a little company? If you pay the right price, your evening will be nice and you can go and send me on my way.
Hey, what's up, YouTube? Caleb of Anger here. After seeing all these perfecting series and whatnot, check out, you know, Nintenderek's Hall of Justice right here. And after talking to my friend, annotation somewhere around here, I decided I'm gonna do it. It's called Trimming Your Garden. And since the only thing I know about this game is plant-type monsters and plants in general, that's what you're getting. Alright. So, let's start off with a card that needs to be in everybody's side deck for this format. Legitimately, like, if you don't cite it, you're an idiot. Fragrant Storm. You will never minus off this card. Honestly, you won't. In my opinion, when I used it, I main three in all my plants. I main three. Basically, you destroy one face-up plant monster on the field and draw a card. If the monster you draw is a plant monster, you can draw once more. Now, that doesn't sound too good for you people that use plants, like, oh, you're giving up a monster. You Fragrant Storm your dandelion. You Fragrant Storm your opponent's fluff tokens, everything, since dandelion is a meta card used in this meta. You will plus. You make them lose a monster, you will plus. And better yet, it's even better when you use Ivy Shackles. Now, on your turn, all your opponent's stuff becomes plant types. So, what you do is you activate your Ivy Shackles, and you go Fragrant Storm. I don't like your, I don't know. Let's not think of anything stupid. I don't like your Dark Armed. Fragrant Storm your Dark Armed. Yeah, they're kind of screwed there. I mean, sure, they can MST it, but then you draw a card off it, so you're not really minusing yourself anyway. Good card. Underrated card. Very good. Very, very good. If you're a plant player, use it. You use this with three of these. I've never had issues with these two cards put together. On to some of the monsters. I mean, I see a lot of plant decks. I mean, I understand Dandy Warrior and Garden Control. And I mean, they run two Titanials or something like that. You run Lord Poison. Now, Lord Poison is a plant-type monster, 1500 attack, 1000 defense. When he's destroyed by battle, you can special summon a plant monster from your graveyard. Any plant monster. That's amazing. That is a free Titanial on the Switch. So, let's say your opponent has a generic monster with 1500 attack points. I can't think of one off the top of my head. You summon Lord Poison. You ram your Lord Poison. Your Lord Poison dies. You grab your Titanial. Still in the battle phase, Titanial swings for 28 direct. Lord Poison is amazing. You set him, they flip him, they destroy him. It's amazing. This card is broke. I run him at 3. The only downfall is you can't pull him from the grave himself or another Lord Poison. So there is no infinite loot, but you can get Dandelion back. Like, I use this with World Tree. You go, World Tree, you got 3 counters. Play Lord Poison. Well, special summon Lord Poison from your graveyard. Lord Poison dies. Get a counter. Pull Dandelion. They attack Dandelion. Get a counter. Get 2 tokens. That's 4 counters on World Tree. Remove 3. Lord Poison. It's an endless cycle. This thing is amazing. Next, I personally run high tributes in my decks, and the next one is Rose Tentacles. Rose Tentacles is a 1 tribute plant monster, 2200 attack, 1200 defense. This card cannot be special summoned. When this card enters battle phase, it gains an additional attack for each plant monster your opponent controls. When it destroys a plant monster, it deals 300 points burned to your opponent. Now, you're thinking, oh, it's a horrible card. Not when you pair it with this thing. Once again, Ivy Shackles will save your butt when you're using Rose Tentacles. I love Rose Tentacles. This card is amazing in this format as well, with all the Hime decks and the Dandy Warriors. It's like, okay, you got your fluff tokens, big whoop, I'll soul exchange or something, summon Rose Tentacles, smack you, then smack your token, then smack you again for 22. I've legitimately gotten this thing up to having 6 attacks in a row with another card, which will be in a later segment. This thing is amazing. I mean, Black Garden Control. Play this card. I mean, legitimately. Play this card. You're like, it's a minus. I don't care. It's a tribute monster. Okay, so its attack goes to 11. Nothing's going to be able to go over 11 easily once you go, okay, summon. Attack your Rose token, and I'll attack your other monster. Not going to do much. Last and not least, Kokimiro Grave Rose. She is a 1900 attack point plant monster. Same Kokimiro effect, discard an Iron Core from your hand, or you can reveal a plant. She is a built-in foolish for level 3 or lower monsters. So you summon her, reveal your plant, standby phase, your standby phase, activate effect, ditch Dandy, ditch Dark Verger, ditch Spore, copy plant, any level 3 or lower monster. It's, heck, what is it? It sets up broken plays in Debris Hame. It's, okay, set, standby phase, ditch Dandy, get 2 tokens, summon Debris, special Dandy. Combos of combo-ness is combo-full. This card is great. I personally love it because it's saved me in so many situations. This card sets up so many plays that it's not funny. So, that's what I have to say. Sub to me. Sub to Nintenderek and Anthony. Team Channel, Team Tonberry is going to be like right here. Shadowreaper of Hell 2. So, guys, Scale of Anger signing out, helping you step by step make your garden look real beautiful.